यदा यदा हि धर्मस्य ग्लानिर्भवति भारत अभ्युत्थानम् अधर्मस्य तदात्मानं सृजाम्यहम् परित्राणाय साधूनां विनाशाय च दुष्कृतां धर्म संस्थापनार्थाय संभवामि युगे युगे।
नमस्ते एंड वेलकम टू जेके योग भगवद गीता समेत। I'm so excited and happy, looking forward to our session with Dr. Kiran Bedi today. Would like to welcome Dr. Kiran Bedi. Namaste, Dr. Bedi.
Thank you. Radhe, Radhe.
Radhe, Radhe. So happy to have you here today with us.
Arjun asks, which I also ask, why must I fight? Why must I fight all the time, Lord Krishna? Why can't I just relax and give up and just go to bed and sleep longer? Lord Krishna says, this is on 1.46, Shloka 1.46. Lord Krishna replies in 2.31. He says, besides considering your duty as a warrior, Arjuna, you should indeed, for a warrior, there is no better engagement than fighting for upholding righteousness. Basically, it's to protect the righteousness, to annihilate the unrighteousness, and to establish the rule of righteousness, which is dharma. That's what he said. Then he said further, it's not befitting for an honorable person. It leads not to higher abodes, but to disgrace. Where you run away from your duty, it's disgraceful. You have to stand up and fight. And it says it does not fit you to yield to this unmanliness. Give up, give up. Such petty weaknesses of heart and arise, not worthy of grief. The wise lament neither for the living nor for the dead. This is 2.3. 4.42, he says, Lord Krishna says, therefore, with the sword of knowledge, O Skion of Bharat, establish yourself in Karma Yoga. Arise, stand up, and take action. That's what Gita is. Gita is telling you to be a master. A master of your life. It's a human document and it's 5,000 years old. It gives us a technique of meditation, enables us reflection, and it also teaches us not to grab but to give.
Dr. Kiran Bedi, it has been such a delight to hear you sharing your experiences. I was just so amazed as the wonderful qualities were shining forth as you were relating your journey. And the one thing that really stood out so much was the purity of intention. I think that is what the Bhagavad Gita tells us, that don't work selfishly. Just do your duty for a higher purpose. And your purity of intention has stood so strongly in all your works and brought you also the fulfillment and joy that manifests as you relate those episodes. In our spiritual journey, we talk about the book Bhagavatam and the person Bhagavat. Now, in this case, we have the book Bhagavad Gita, and the way you have related your own dedication to duty and selfless service, I was just thinking that those qualities of the Bhagavad Gita have really manifested in your life by the grace of Lord Krishna upon you. And for all our listeners on JKO Global Summit, this has been a tremendous treat. We'd like to thank you for having spent your day studying the Gita with your sincerity to share that nectar with all of us. Heartfelt gratitude and appreciation.
Thank you, Swamiji, for what a great, rare opportunity.
The Gita also defines who a devoted personal is. And see these words hitting right at our core. The devoted professional is one with sublime knowledge. That's point number one, good quality of knowledge. Number two, who continuously updates himself or herself with his or her own efforts. So number one, you have good quality knowledge. Number two, you keep on trying to improve it. And number three, avoiding degradation. So you keep on trying to improve yourself, and you also make sure that you are not slipping back. Why do we need knowledge? We need knowledge because we are surrounded by a lot of darkness. This darkness is born of ignorance. And how will we dispel it? We'll dispel it with the light of knowledge. And now see this? Is this written for COVID times? Written so many thousands of years ago. So much of darkness around us. So much of misinformation floating around on WhatsApp, on Facebook, on Twitter. Where does this misinformation come from? It's fed by ignorance. How will you fight this ignorance, and how will you fight this darkness? With knowledge. Whose job is it to fight ignorance related to health? It's everybody's responsibility, but it is my responsibility, first of all, as a healthcare professional. And that is why we coined a term known as quaternary prevention. So most of us in medicine and nursing will know of primary, secondary, and tertiary prevention. Quaternary prevention is a concept which says that you should try to avoid over-investigation, over-treatment of disease. Just do what is required. And quaternary prevention enjoins us to promote information and prevent misinformation. Quaternary prevention enjoins us to do exactly what Lord Krishna told us so many centuries ago. Dispel the darkness of ignorance with the illuminating light of knowledge. So spread knowledge.